Thank you so much for your warm introduction. I feel truly privileged to have been invited by the American Jewish Committee to address a global audience committed to the preservation of the values of democracy and human rights. As we know, doing so entails combating all forms of racism and xenophobia, like anti-Semitism and the terrorist attacks of such groups that promote anti-Semitism. I'm happy to be here. For the AEJC has always been an indispensable OAS institutional and personal partner, helping bolster causes that are at the centers of the OAS mandate. Thus, I have adopted the IRA working definition and designated Hezbollah a terrorist organization back in 2019, and I have been working hard to ensure that the countries of the Americas follow suit. Unfortunately, anti-Semitism continues to raise its ugly persistence in the hemisphere. And due to the current episode of violence in Israel and attacks, the Jewish state permanently suffer at the hands of terrorist Hamas, we are witnessing anti-Semitic campaigns in many places, trying to delegitimize Israel and calling for its disappearance. That is the reason why, as you might be aware, we have continuously declared our solidarity with the State of Israel in its rights, and also why we have unambiguously and unequivocally declared Hamas a terrorist organization, urging others in the Americas to do so as well. As my good friend David Harris has said, this is a moment for moral clarity and no moral foe. I want to say it loud and clear. Calling for the disappearance of the State of Israel is itself an act of terrorism. And it also is, plain and simple, anti-Semitism. Our hemisphere, impacted by the pandemic and experiencing a weakening of the democratic fabric in several societies, is facing an uptick in anti-Semitism, which threatens all minorities and endangers the principles of inclusion, respect for diversity, and social peace promoted by the inter-American system. Around the world, the growth in anti-Jewish attitudes and behavior has led different nations, including the US and Canada, to establish commissioners to monitor and combat anti-Semitism. The European Union, homologous to the OAS, has a coordinator on combating anti-Semitism and fostering Jewish life. We are convinced that our hemisphere needs to be adequately prepared to face the global threat of anti-Semitism in the same way that many other nations and democratic international bodies are doing so. Anti-Semitism has had dramatic and violent dimensions. We ought not to forget several tragic instances, the terrorist attack against Amia in 1994, the use of anti-Semitism as an ideological political tool in the hemispheric dictatorship, the terrorist attack against the embassy of Israel in Argentina, and the vile attack against the Chilean Jewish community, all clear examples of threats, not only against Jewish communities, but against the societies to which they belong. For all these reasons, I am pleased to announce today from this AJC stage that I have issued an executive order to establish the position of Commissioner of the OAS for monitoring and combating anti-Semitism. I can tell you that among his/her main responsibilities will be first to actively promote adoption and implementation by all countries in the region of the IRA definition of anti-Semitism, and second, to vigorously engage member states and civil society organizations in the hemisphere to raise awareness of the need to remain alert to all forms of anti-Semitism, those that manifest themselves through terrorist acts, as well as those that do so more in subtle ways. Towards that end, AJC and the OAS are already working on the publication of a Latin American version of the handbook for the practical use of the IRA working definition of anti-Semitism, authored by the European Commission. We have been discussing different forms of cooperation with our homologous European Union on these issues, a synergy that will strengthen our shared values and principles. In addition, following the United Nations, European Union, and several other international organizations, the OIS has also applied for membership as an institutional partner of the IRA. It is our hope that all these critical steps will help ensure not only the well-being of Jews and other minorities in the region, while consolidating democratic values and practices. This will send the clearest of messages that Latin America has no tolerance today and in the future for the destructive forces of anti-Semitism and terrorism.